Edges that are beveled catch light and shadow differently than sharp edges, making the image look more natural and believable. In Blender, Ctrl plus B bevels edges and polygons. To bevel points, use Ctrl plus Shift plus B. These functions are also in the Tool Palette or under Vertex or Edge menu. While using the bevel command, you can turn the mouse wheel to set the number of segments. When called from the Tool Palette, a yellow path with a circle shows up to adjust bevel strength. Hold the mouse button and turn the wheel to set subdivisions. We just saw the values Width and Segments. Width type decides how the strength of an edge or its distance is figured out. Shape changes how round the bevel is. At 0.5, it's completely round or convex. Under 0.5, it becomes concave, which means it curves inward, and at 0, it doesn't curve inside at all. An even number of segments results in a step-like, non-smooth transition. If you use a value of 1, it doesn't make a bevel, but instead it adds more splits to the surfaces next to it. The material index assigns a different material to the newly created surfaces. This index corresponds to the respective material slot of the 3D model. Harden Normals auto-calculates polygon transitions for a smooth look. This turns on Auto Smooth under Data in Normals. Clamp Overlap stops the bevel when an edge touches another. Loop Slide aims for even surface subdivision, important for unevenly sized surfaces. In the lower section, you have control over how the rounding is calculated, and under Custom, you can also determine the shape yourself. We can also use the Bevel command as a modifier, allowing us to set all parameters in a parametric manner. In the modifier, we have all the settings available in the Bevel tool, but here the options are arranged slightly differently. The unique aspect of the bevel modifier is that it allows us to bevel individual edges or points with varying degrees of intensity. There are several methods available to achieve this. This feature is located under Limit Method. By default, it is set to Angle, meaning that any edge with a bend of 30 degrees or more will be beveled. In our example, these edges would only be beveled if they have an angle of at least 30 degrees. With the weight method, edges with a weight value higher than 0 are rounded. In the model's edge mode, under Item in Edge Data, you can individually set the bevel weight for each edge. This allows you to determine the weight for each edge, which is then adjusted using the amount setting. In the viewport, the strength of the bevel weight is represented by a blue tone. If you can't see this in your setup, you can enable or disable it through Show Overlays in Mesh Edit mode using the Bevel button. For the vertices of the selected edge, this adjustment is made using the mean bevel weight value. However, to do this, you need to switch to Vertices in the Bevel modifier. You can select each point individually and determine its influence with the bevel weight setting. The weight method rounds off edges that have a weight value greater than 0. By right-clicking, I can also set this value directly in the viewport with the Edge Bevel Weight command. We can also save our own selection of edges or points in a vertex map and use it for beveling. This is similar to using selection tags in Cinema 4D. To do this, we change the Limit method to Vertex Group. Directly below, you can select the corresponding vertex map. To create a vertex map in Blender, go to Object Data Properties and then Vertex Groups. Click on the plus sign to create a new group, select the edges you want to bevel. Click on Assign to load your selection into the group. You can rename the group with a double click. Finally, in the modifier, make sure to select the vertex group you just created. We can simulate the rounding of edges by controlling it through the material. Edge rounding can be simulated using materials without affecting the geometry. This method is suitable for quick visual improvements, but not ideal for close-ups, as it's essentially a visual trick. To implement this, connect the bevel node to the normal slot of the material and adjust the radius on the bevel node to control the effect's strength. That's everything about beveling for now. If this video was helpful, please give a thumbs up, and if you want more videos, please subscribe to the channel. Have a great day and see you next time.